Oh, look at this. To be able to just step out your dorm and have all this. Libraries, laboratories, lecture halls.
It's pretty great, huh?
Oh, yes. You know, your grandfather and I had to drive your Uncle Isaac 60 miles to get to his school. Every day, an hour and a half each way. We would leave at the crack of dawn and then go back in the evenings. That was the only decent place around. 60 miles away.
Thank you.
Thank you. For what?
You do what you have to do. I know it's hard. I've been where you're sitting. But there are some silver linings.
Like what?
Look, nobody wants to go through something like this. But I'm incredibly grateful for some of the things it's given me. I mean, we've started organizations. We've contributed to science. I mean, I've written a book. I've done things I never thought I would do or could do. Most of all, hey, I don't know many people who can truly say this, but I've just been a mom helping her kid live his life to his fullest potential.
I just don't know if I have the strength.
Oh, yeah, you do. Yes, you do. If you believe in something.
If you make it happen, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you get an idea, you're excited, you want to implement it right away.
Yes, I do.
Then take a minute, stand right here, take a deep breath. Hold on to that feeling. These are terrific ideas that I do want to implement. But be patient. These are difficult clients to reach. Change isn't easy for them. And this won't be the only sit down. There'll be meetings and meetings.
And more meetings!
And he was waiting there, outside the room, as one of these meetings was going on, to decide if and when and where and how he could possibly take a bus to work when. Tell them what you did. He just got up and...
And took the bus to work.
Well, not just one bus.
Two.
Two buses, 6 miles, umpteen different stops.
I just want to get to work.
What was it like when you got there?
Bite.
Was the president there?
No.
First lady?
No.
Princesses?
Well... There was definitely one. Now remember, this was the Academy Award. The most famous stars in the world are there. The biggest of them are nominated. Jane Fonda, Kathleen Turner, Sissy Spacek, Sigourney Weaver. The envelope is open, and the winner is a 21-year-old deaf girl from Chicago.
Miley.
That's right, Miley Matlin. She was, and still is, the youngest person ever to have received an Oscar for Best Actress. And you know what she taught me?
What?
They are capable of doing so much more that we're not even aware of. When Dove was 9, I read about this woman whose son was also autistic and who was able to teach her kid to communicate by pointing to letters on a chart. So we flew her out. She was able to teach Dove to do the same thing. And I asked him, I said, what have you been doing the last 9 years? And you know what he spelled out?
What?
Listening. He could spell. He could read. He had normal intelligence. He was just different. Just like you found out your kid's different. Just like you and I are different. But for those of us
who are more different, I have to put more effort to convince those who are less different that we can do the same thing that they can, but just differently.
Hi, how are you? Hi. Today we're gonna make some changes around here. We're going to do things a little more independently. Isaac, we're gonna start with you.
Back then, people would keep family like Isaac in their attics. Literally, wouldn't even talk about them. Ah, there they are.
Grandpa, Uncle Isaac.
Hey, oh, so Grandpa. Good to see you.
How you doing?
Hey.
Hope, there is a whole world of good people out there. Hope is a very good thing.